A reading from Romans. I appeal to you, therefore, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds, so that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. For by the grace given to me, I say to everyone among you not to think of yourself more highly than you ought to think, but to think with sober judgment, each according to the measure of faith that God has assigned. For as in one body we have many members, and not all the members have the same functions, so we, who are many, are one body in Christ, and individually we are members one of another. We have gifts that differ according to the grace given to us: prophecy in proportion to faith, ministry in ministering, the teacher in teaching. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A few years ago, a few of us went to Des Moines, Iowa for the day to meet with the Gallup organization. Now, you know them as a polling organization probably, but they are a very significant research industry as well, and they do a lot of work to help the church. And while we were there, what we learned is that they believe that one of the most important factors in a healthy and thriving congregation comes down to one thing: the degree to which members are engaged in ministry according to their unique gifts. And there's that word again, engagement. Now, everyone should be engaged, and everyone should be engaged according to their strengths. So Gallup developed a kind of gift inventory, turned it into a book and an online tool. The book is Living Your God-Given Strengths. And Jerry McKenzie in our church is a coach of that, and others are trained to help you. How many of you have taken that and know your strengths? Look at some of your hands up. Everybody can do that. Go meet Jerry afterward, and you can learn more about that. But there are 33 of them that they list in that. Among my top are strategic and command. Watch out for me, you know. For those of you who have been sitting out there, though, in the pew, standing still, sitting quietly, watching others engage, I have a question for you today. What would this church be if it were only a reflection of your level of engagement? What could it be if you were more engaged? And for those of you who are often exhausted in serving the church, frustrated and feeling overworked because you have so many jobs, I have a surprising question for you. Why don't you let some of that go? Why don't you do only, really, what is best for you to do according to your strengths and gifts, and let someone else do what is best for them. We are all called to worship, learn, give, and serve, but to do so within our strengths.